NFLGamePlan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook. Bring you our 2013 SWAC Championship game preview presented by Coach Lehman's Academy between the Southern Jaguars and the Jackson State Tigers. Now let's take a look at some keys to victory for both teams, starting with Jackson State.
Jackson State enters the SWAC Championship game with a record of 8-3, and all season long I've been impressed with their defense. The Tigers are very athletic at the second and third level of that defense, led by cornerback Quad Cox, who's one of the best defensive players in the country. On offense, Jackson State does a lot of damage on the ground with quarterback Clayton Moore and running back Tommy Gooden being an excellent 1-2 combination on the read option. Now this week versus the Jaguars, it's important for Moore to avoid mistakes and for this Tigers offense to pay off in the red zone. It's been a struggle for consistency in that department all season long. Now let's move over to Southern in this ballgame, and the Jaguars are fresh off a 40-17 victory over Grambling in the Bayou Classic, and quarterback Dre Joseph has been outstanding all season long, and it also helps that he's throwing to a stud at wide receiver in Lee Doss. The senior wideout hauled in 68 receptions for over 1,000 yards this season and 10 touchdowns. When we look at the defense of the Jags, you see the talent in the back end, but you look at that front seven and see 4.6 yards a carry given up on the ground. That obviously has to tighten up this week versus a solid rushing attack of Jackson State. You look at junior linebacker Daniel Brown, who leads the team in tackles. He has to make sure his guys are where they're supposed to be pre-snap, especially versus Jackson State, where not only do you have to be aligned properly, but disciplined as well. Now, here are some coaching points for both teams in this ballgame. For Jackson State, the A-gap and B-gap pressure has to be on point. I believe the Southern Jaguars offensive line right now is struggling to recognize stunts and pick up the blitz so they can get some pressure on Dre Joseph, but it has to come from the inside. And on the defense side of the football, you look at cornerback Quad Cox and linebacker Ryan Griffin, who's 5'11", 185, more of a hybrid safety type of player. I think they can combo cover Lee Doss and take him out of the ballgame and force Joseph to go to other targets consistently. And on offense, they have to stay efficient. Small ball is the approach, chew up that TOP, and keep the ball away from that Jaguars' explosive offense. And for Southern in this ballgame, they have to get early stops on defense. This is a football team that gives up 4.6 yards a carry on the ground, and that's music to Jackson State's ears because they would love to run the football up and down the field against Southern, so they have to get those early stops and put the Tigers in passing situations. And openers are vital for Southern. This is a football team that starts the game rather slowly on offense, and also coming out of halftime, they're a little bit sluggish, so they have to make sure they open up the game and open up the second half on fire on both sides of the ball. And they have to play with better run fits. That's how you stop the run. It's about attitude. It's about being where you're supposed to be. And it all starts as well with playing with better run fits, and they can have some success versus Jackson State. The X factor for Jackson State will be their passing game. The Tigers do a great job of operating off play action, and they have legit deep threats in Zach Pendleton and Toby Singleton, but the passing game still must be consistent from down to down in order for these guys to have success. And for Southern, it's going to be the ground game. This has been the biggest asset to offensive success this year for Southern, and if they're able to get that ground game going very early, it's going to take a lot of pressure off that offensive line and pass protection, which has been leaky as of late. Now here are some 2014 draft prospects you want to keep an eye on in this ballgame. For Jackson State, two guys on the defensive side of the football, Quad Cox, 6 feet, 185 pounds, and linebacker Todd Wilcher, 6'1", 230. Quad Cox is one of the best cornerbacks in the country regardless of division, and he has an outstanding matchup this week versus Southern's pro prospects in wide receiver Lee Doss, the talented wideout, 6'2", 180 pounds, and also quarterback Dre Joseph, one of the better quarterbacks in the FCS. But when you look at the junior talent on both teams, you're going to be excited about the prospects moving forward, but these are the senior guys that I think have a lot of pro potential. Before Lim Barney went on to a Hall of Fame career with the Detroit Lions, he was an outstanding three-time All-SWAC performer at Jackson State, finished his career with 26 career interceptions, and was also an outstanding punter, averaging 41.6 yards a punt and 42.5 yards a punt as a junior and senior. Before he became a two-time AFL All-Star and a two-time NFL All-Pro, Rich Tombstone Jackson was an outstanding stud defensive lineman for the Southern Jaguars from 1962 to 1965, and is definitely one of the best players in program history, and is also one of the more underrated players in NFL history and should be in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. I like Southern in this ballgame. I look at their raw offense now as opposed to when they played Jackson State earlier in the season. They're a lot more balanced, and I think their defense will step up and be able to put Jackson State in obvious passing situations, making them one-dimensional. So I think the Jaguars will win the 2013 SWAC Championship. And I also want to give a special shout-out to our sponsor, Coach Lehman's Academy. Visit the website at www.coachlehmansacademy.com.